Welcome you all for the next video session on module 3, which is probability distribution. So here in this session, we shall discuss about exponential distribution and problems on it. So let us see what is an exponential distribution and how exactly it is different from binomial and Poisson distribution. So in the earlier cases, we have come across the binomial distribution, Poisson distribution, and I have also told you that the binomial and Poisson distributions are related to random variables. Whereas exponential and another distribution which we are going to discuss in the later cases is going to be normal distribution. This exponential and normal distributions are related to continuous random variable. Okay, so now let us see what exactly exponential distribution is. A random variable x is called an exponential random variable with parameter lambda greater than 0. And its PDF is given by fx of x. PDF here is probability density function of an exponential distribution is fx of x, which is equal to, it takes the value lambda e to the power of minus lambda x for all the values of x greater than 0. And in all other cases, this fx of x remains to be 0 in all other cases. So this is a probability density function of an exponential distribution. The corresponding cumulative density function for an exponential distribution is denoted as capital fx of x, and it is equal to 1 minus e to the power of minus lambda x for all the values of x greater than or equal to 0, and fx of x remains 0 for all the values x less than 0, means when x takes the negative values. So the graphical representation of the probability density function and the cumulative distribution function for the exponential distributions are as follows. This is for the probability density function. It is a linear curve, and this is also a linear curve, but it is in the reverse process. That is a cumulative distribution function. It is 1 minus e to the power of minus lambda x for all the positive values of x, and this is lambda e to the power of minus lambda x for all the positive values of x. So let us see mean, variance and standard deviation of this exponential distribution. So from the probability density function of an exponential distribution, we know that fx of x is a lambda e to the power of minus lambda x. This exists for all the positive values of x greater than 0. And this fx of x remains 0 in all other cases. So for the continuous random variable, the expectation of x is, that is the mean value of x, is defined as integral from minus infinity to infinity x fx of x into dx. So this f of x can be substituted from here, and accordingly we have to change the limits. So e of x is, this is x greater than 0. Greater than 0 means you can start from 0 and goes behind 0 till infinity. So the limits are going to be from 0 to infinity x, and f of x we are going to replace with lambda e to the power of minus lambda x. Therefore the limits are from 0 to infinity dx. And the another case, in all other cases, fx is 0, so we need not write it. So take out the lambda, which is a common term, x and e to the power of minus lambda x into dx. And now we have to perform the integration. To perform the integration, we have to apply integration by parts. So integration by parts, and this e of x is as it is, lambda is a constant, I can write it. And we have to identify the first function and the second function. So here I'll take first function as x and second function as e power minus lambda x. So when we do the integration, first function as it is, integral of second function is e power minus lambda x by minus lambda minus differentiation of first function, which is 1, and integration of the first function, which we have already done. So again, when we do integration of this e to the power of minus lambda x by minus lambda, and already minus lambda was there, so it is minus lambda the whole square. This is to be evaluated between the limits 0 and infinity. So limits are from 0 to infinity. Take out lambda, as which is already a common term. When we substitute the upper limit, e to the power of minus lambda. So e power minus lambda is 1 by e to the power of infinity. When we substitute lambda is equal to infinity, e to the power of minus infinity we get, which is nothing but 1 by infinity. 1 by e to the power of infinity is infinity, and 1 by infinity is 0. So we get a 0 for both upper limit as well as the lower limit. So when x is equal to 0, when we substitute here, this term becomes 0. For the second term, for this term, when we substitute the upper limit, e to the power of minus infinity by infinity, we are substituting for x, e to the power of minus infinity by minus lambda the whole square. Again, e power minus infinity gives us the value 0. So this is 0. And for the lower limit, when x is equal to 0, e power minus 0 is 1 by minus lambda square. So which gives the answer as the lambda which is there outside is as it is, and inside we had got 1 by lambda square, and therefore which concludes e of x is equal to 1 by lambda. That is a mean for exponential distribution. So once after the evaluation of the mean, we always evaluate the expression for variance. Variance expansion is e of x square minus e of x whole square. So I know what is e of x, just we have evaluated the mean. But e of x square to be evaluated, only then we will be able to get the expansion expression for variance. So let us consider e of x square first and evaluate it, and later we will define what is variance. So e of x square here is integral minus infinity to infinity x square fx of x into dx. This is by the definition of continuous distributions. So now, and this f of x exists only for the values which is values of x which are greater than 0. So x values are greater than 0, it starts from 0 and goes up to plus infinity. So x square is as it is, f of x between the limit 0 and infinity is lambda e power minus lambda x by the definition. So lambda is a constant, you can write it outside, and x square into e to the power of minus lambda x to be integrated. So again there are two functions and integration by parts to be applied here. So how do we do the integration by parts? Integral of u into v. So if I consider this as a first function and this as a second function, first function as it is, integral of v minus differentiation of u into integral of v again. So already we have found integration of v, this to be integrated again and written it here. So that is integration by parts. So when we do so, when we do the integration by parts for this integral, we get it as lambda x square e to the power of minus lambda x, which is a second function. Integral of that is e power minus lambda x by minus lambda. And now second term, differentiation of x square is 2x, and this term to be integrated again. So minus 1 by lambda is a constant. Integration of e power minus lambda is e power minus lambda by minus lambda again. So denominator becomes minus lambda the whole square plus, since again this 2x, differentiation of 2x is 2. So we are applying the Bernoulli's rule here. Integration by parts, since we are extending the terms, you can apply Bernoulli's rule. So differentiation of 2x is 2. And integration of this again, e to the power of minus lambda x by minus lambda the whole cube between the limits 0 and infinity. So Bernoulli's rule here is integral of u into v is nothing but u, identify the first function and second function. This is first and this is second. If we observe u into v dash. V dash here is integral of v minus differentiation of u. So I'll write this as u1 and v double dash means double integration of v. Again plus u2 means the second differentiation of u and third integration of v. Likewise, we will be keep moving it till u becomes 0. Either the u or v should become 0. Okay, so with that and on substituting the limits here, after integration and substituting the limits, we get lambda for infinity. The first term is 0. Here e power minus infinity again, so that is 0. E power minus infinity, that is 0. So for all the three, for upper limit, all the three terms will be 0. And for the lower limit, that is when x is equal to 0, you get x square here. 0 multiplied to anything is 0. So we have entered 0 here. And again we have x here and lower limit is 0. So 0 multiplied to anything is 0. And this term, x is equal to 0, e power minus 0, that is e power 0 is 1, 2 by minus lambda cube. So when we simplify this, minus whole cube is minus. And there is 1 lambda here which gets cancelled with this. So we get e of x square is equal to 2 by lambda square. So now we can define the variance. Variance is sigma x square. It is represented as sigma x square. And it is defined as e of x square minus e of x whole square. So E of x square, we have evaluated, it is 2 by lambda square minus E of x is, we have evaluated the mean is 1 by lambda the whole square. So when we simplify this, it is 1 by lambda square again. So you can take the LCM. LCM is, so this term is going to be 1 by lambda square. So we have already have 2 minus 2 by lambda square. So lambda square is a common term, and the denominator you can take the LCM, 2 minus 1, which is 1 by lambda square. So sigma x square, that is a variance, is 1 by lambda square, and we know that the standard deviation is square root of variance. So square root of 1 by lambda square gives us 1 by lambda. These are the expressions that we have for exponential distribution for mean, variance and standard deviation. So we shall see a few examples. The time which has been given in us required to repair a machine is exponentially distributed with the parameter lambda is equal to 1 by 2. What is the probability that the repair time exceeds 2 hours? The question is clear. The exponential distribution has been asked and the lambda value has been given, and we have to find when x is exceeds 2 hours, means the value of x is more than 2 hours. So let us take capital letter x, which represents the time to repair a machine. The density function of an x is given by probability density function of exponential distribution is f of x is equal to lambda e to the power of minus x, because our x value given is greater than or equal to 0. So here lambda value is half, which has been given. So substitute for lambda and e to the power of minus x by 2. And the value here x is positive. So now we have to find to repair a machine which takes more than 2 hours, p of x greater than 2. So by the definition, we know that integral from minus infinity to infinity, but here x takes the value 2 to infinity, because greater than 2 has been considered. So 2 to infinity f of x dx. So f of x substitute for f of x, which is lambda e to the power of minus lambda x, and substituting for lambda we get this. And half is a constant, you can write it outside. Integral of e power minus x by 2, and integration of this function is e power x minus x by 2 by minus half between the limits 2 and infinity. So when we substitute the upper limit, e to the power of minus infinity is 0, and when we substitute the lower limit, e to the power of minus 2 by 2, which is 1, e power minus 1 by minus 1 again. So minus of this. Okay, so when we simplify further, it is the answer is going to be 0.3679. So look at another example. Assume that the length of the phone call in minutes is an exponentially random variable x with parameter lambda is equal to 1 by 10. If someone arrives at a phone booth just before you arrive, find the probability that you will have to wait less than 5 minutes, between 5 to 10 minutes waiting period. So here it is clearly given, it is a problem related to exponential distribution, and the value of lambda here is 1 by 10. The probability density function of an exponential distribution is given as fx, which is lambda e power minus lambda x with x greater than 0, and fx remains 0 in all other cases. So here lambda value is 1 by 10. So this 1 by 10 e to the power of minus x by 10 for all the values of x greater than 0. That is our function f of x. The first question is how long you have to wait. So if you the question says that if you have to wait less than 5 minutes, and the second question is between 5 and 10 minutes. So less than 5 minutes is being asked us to find probability of waiting period, which is less than 5 minutes. So p of x, px, which is x less than 5. So by the definition, it is integral 0 to 5, less than 5. Usually the standard definition says from 0 to infinity. And here it is given as less than 5. Less than 5 means it will start from 5 and it will go up to 5. So 0 to 5, fx of x. And f of x from the previous slide, it is e power minus x by 10 into 1 by 10. 1 by 10 is a constant term, so we can write it outside. And now we can perform the integration. So integration of e power minus x by 10 is e power minus x by 10 minus 1 by 10 between the limits 0 and 5. So when we substitute the upper limit where x is equal to 5, e to the power of minus 5 by 10 and 1 by 10, here this 1 by 10 and this 1 by 10 cancels, and for the lower limit it is e to the power of 0. So here it is e to the power of minus half, there is one more minus, and e power 0 is 1. On simplifying this we get 0.393. And the second sub-question was the waiting period, which varies between 5 to 10 minutes. So 5 to 10 minutes, x varies between 5 to 10 minutes, and the limits for your integral will be 5 to 10 fx of x dx. And f of x we have already found, which is e power minus x by 10 into 1 by 10. Since it is a constant, we have written it outside, and integrate this function, substitute the limits by 5 to 10, and we get the answer as 0.239. Look at another example. Suppose the duration x in minutes of a long distance call from your home follows exponential law with the probability density function f of x is equal to 1 by 5 e to the power of minus x by 5, where x is greater than or equal to 0. Otherwise, it is f of x is 0. So we have to find p of x greater than 5 and p of x varies between 3 and 6. We have to find the mean and variance of variable x here. So we know that the exponential distribution, for a exponential distribution, the probability density function is f of x lambda e power minus lambda x for all the values of x greater than or equal to 0. Otherwise, f of x is 0. So mean value for exponential distribution is, mean value for exponential distribution is 1 by lambda, and the variance is 1 by lambda square. So from the definition or from the given problem, it is clear that lambda value is 1 by 5 because it is given as 1 by 5 into e to the power of minus x by 5. From that we can observe lambda is equal to 1 by 5. Therefore the mean value is 5 and the variance is square of which is 25. So now we have to evaluate p of x greater than 5, means it starts from 5 and goes up to infinity. So f of x dx, f of x is 1 by 5 e to the power of minus x by 5 dx. So 1 by 5 is a constant, keep it as it is. Integration of this is this, between the limits 5 and infinity. For upper limit it is 0, and for the lower limit we get minus e power minus 1. And the value is 0.36788. And the second sub question was asked us to find p of the value of x which varies between 3 to 6. So your integral limits we will have from 3 to 6 f of x dx. So f of x is also been given with a suitable lambda value, and we have to integrate that. Integration of e power minus x by 5 is this, between the limits 3 and 6. E to the power of minus 6 by 5 minus e power minus 3 by 5. On substituting the limits and simplifying this, e power minus 6 by 5 is 0.5488 minus this term gives us 0.3012. On simplifying further, we get the value of probability of x varying between 3 and 6 is 0.2476. So that is about it. Thank you.